Hi, I'm Mike. Ever heard the saying, don't reinvent the wheel? Well, it turns out that might have been the worst advice ever given, as today we do just that and look at the future of the tire and reinvent how we roll on our Wyoming Life. This is our Wyoming Life. My family and I came to the ranch a few years ago to help my father-in-law in his failing health. Since he passed away, we've been running it, learning as we go and sharing with you as we explore the ranch life and escape the ordinary. The world is fast-paced. Things are constantly changing. We really have no control over how fast technology moves around us, and sometimes it's easy to get overwhelmed. That is one of the things that draws people to the ranch life. It seems easygoing. Things never change, and some things don't. Each and every year, we deal with the same large milestones: calving, branding, haying, market harvests, and eventually the selling of calves, and winter feeding for the herd. Those are the things that I hope never change on the ranch. There are benchmarks, and each season we finish gives you a sense of accomplishment and pride in your work. But just like any other business, there are many support structures that make sure that those milestones are able to be completed. We don't have a staff here on the ranch, so those departments are made up by Erin and myself. We're our own secretaries, assistants, and payroll departments. HR consists of me complaining to a cow who really doesn't care much anyway, and the R&D department on the ranch is only what we can invent and produce on our own. And in our own shop. While technology on the ranch may seem at a standstill, it's the little things that have changed how we do our job. In the 1940s, ranches saw their first non-horse-drawn implements as tractors move in to take their place. In fact, by the 70s, horses were no longer used on the ranch at all when Gilbert discovered three and four-wheelers. And although it was the end of an era, a romantic notion on the ranch, it enabled us to work more efficiently, faster, and with less downtime, especially when you're running the place on your own. Now, it's been a while since we've seen a big innovation like that one on the ranch, something that's changed how we do things and made things easier and saved us money in the long run. One of the biggest expenses on the ranch is travel. Since we replace the horses with tractors and other motorized vehicles, that expense can literally be traced to where the rubber meets the road. On the ranch, between all of our tractors, balers, ATVs, trucks, and trailers, and anything else with a wheel, we have over 80 tires that need constant upkeep. Tire pressures, wear and tear, and sometimes even just rot from the lack of use can cause a serious hiccup in our operation. So it makes sense that over the past year, I've gotten to know our friends at Michelin, a tire manufacturer whose U.S. offices are based in Greenville, South Carolina. If you looked at our budget on the ranch, tires and their maintenance is a huge part of it. We're constantly repairing and replacing tires. Over the life of the Gator, for example, we've went through 5 set of tires, and that's just for a little bit over 14,000 miles. But now, changes are coming to the tire industry and how farms and ranches can deal with tires, their upkeep, and their replacement. For the past 20 years, Michelin has been working to innovate not only how many things can be done here on the ranch, but how the entire world looks at tires. This, right here, is a Tweel tire. Now, it's unlike any tire I've ever seen. Recently, I got a chance to visit the Tweel factory in Greenville and see exactly how these tires are built. What the heck? what the heck is this? Oh, there we go. Okay. This is a non-disclosure agreement. And yeah, I signed it before I went in the factory, so I can't actually show you how they're made. But luckily, we have a set of Tweels right here in the shop. And in all reality, you don't have to know how a tire is put together. You just have to know it's gonna work. I've been out doing chores this morning in the Bobcat, cleaning barns, removing a retaining wall, and working at cleaning up the dump. All of these work sites are dangerous. In the barns, you can easily get stuck. While landscaping, you can run over a piece of concrete, breaking down the sidewalls of your tires. And the dump, well, it's a minefield of nails and sharp materials, all waiting for soft rubber of a tire to puncture and ruin your day. The Bobcat, while a very useful tool on the ranch, is the most prone to tire problems because of the work it does. Downtime is inevitable, and downtime costs money. A single Bobcat tire can cost up to $300, and when you build a tire budget that can cover almost 100 tires on the ranch, we begin looking at cost per hour on some tires. Our calculations on the ranch figure that for every 1,000 hours, we're gonna have to replace the tires on the skid steer. We budget about $2,000 for that, or $2 per tire hour cost. That's pretty high, but we wanna make sure we have ourselves covered. But what if there were a way to cut that $2 per hour cost in half, or maybe even a third? That's where the Tweels come into play. And Michelin has been letting us try these Tweel SSLs on our Bobcat. Man, I wish it was that easy. Tweels weigh around 250 pounds a piece, and while the old Bobcat tires are air-filled and easy to move around, these things are a bit more labor-intensive. The Tweels also stand about an inch higher than my stock tires. That shouldn't cause too much of an issue, but we'll see. With all the tires on, we can get a look at how these Tweels work. The tires are attached to the machine with an inner hub. That hub is attached to the actual treads with a number of ribs or spokes. These spokes are what support the weight of the machine, but not in the way you may think they do, or at least I didn't think. For me, it's almost upside down. The machine actually hangs from the spokes. You can see that on these spokes, the spokes on the bottom of the tire, they're bending. They're giving way to the weight of the machine on top of them. The spokes on the top of the tire, they're stretched tight, with an incredible amount of tension on them. That in turn gives you a bit of suspension, unless of course you're working in the frigid cold. Right now with the temperature below freezing, these tires have no give, and the ride is almost excruciating over frozen calipers. But if you take it slow, it gets better. And I can tell you, when I come back, I will be avoiding this field of landmines. Back at the cow barn, we can compare those air-filled tires that we ran earlier to the new Tweels. Air-filled tires do allow a little bit more traction in this situation. The ground is frozen and very slippery. Inside the barn where it's thawed, we're not able to get the same push into the barn with the Tweels. This is probably also due to the weather and the freezing temperatures. The rubber on the Tweels is extremely hard, which means it's gonna last, but it's also not as pliable in this weather, leading to some slipping. Outside the barn, I can't really see or feel much difference between the Tweels and the air-filled tires. Each hold their own just fine, although the Tweels seem to have a bit more traction here, and they are controlling any side slip better than the pneumatic tires, keeping me on the side of the hill a little bit better. Our other chores are repeated also as we take more out of the retaining wall around the farmhouse, which we'll feather out and actually replace with more slope lawn this spring. The blocks pop free with the same amount of effort as before, but again, the tires do seem to give less, not squashing down from the weight of the work. And while driving over obstacles, the Tweels still are not flexing that much in the cold, even after driving for about an hour. There are certain advantages to the Tweels, which are obvious, and maybe the most obvious that might be seen at the dump, where we continue to move material around to pile up and be removed. The dump on most ranches is an area where few love to work with machinery because the danger of losing tires. But now with the Tweels, we can concentrate on cleaning this area up once and for all. And for that, I'm extremely happy. All in all, I'm pretty impressed with the Tweel tires. And not only because they're available for skid steers, but also they can be fitted to a number of zero turn mowers, side by sides, and even ATVs. Tires like these may just be the future of tires, and someday you might even see them rolling down the highway. The price tag is what's going to limit you seeing them everywhere, at least for a little while, as they're pretty expensive to manufacture. I said that I couldn't tell you anything about what I saw in the factory, but I'll tell you this, as long as you don't tell too many people. Right now, it takes days to make one of these tires, and they can cost you anywhere from 3 to 4 times the price of a traditional tire. Of course, they last a lot longer, and if you're in a situation like we are with the skid steer, where we're going to be going through tires at the rate of up to 4 a year, it might be worthwhile to take a look and see how Tweels can eventually save you money in the long run. I am extremely looking forward to continuing to test these tires on our skid steer. The weather's gonna warm up, and I'm sure just like the air-filled tires, these will perform differently, and that is really something to look forward to. I, of course, wanna thank Michelin for allowing us to test these tires. They aren't paying us anything to do so. In fact, I'm really impressed that they told me that they expect me to be honest and unbiased. So that's what they're gonna get, good or bad. The tires, they do turn heads. I saw that, people going down the highway. They look cool, and so far, they're getting the job done. Our goal this year, it sounds bad, but it's to break them. So subscribe and help me as we explore the ranch life and really escape the ordinary. Have a great week, and thanks for joining me in our Wyoming Life.